love entertainment. How many of you love entertainment? Say yes. Yes, 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 absolutely. So here's what I'm going to ask you. Who wants to come on the stage with me? Because there is a special experience that we are planning. We need 10 people. Raise your hands and Raisa will bring you in because it's a surprise. It's a surprise. You have to join me on the stage. Okay, go ahead, Raisa. Bring Stacy, Cindy, Tony, Humera, Deborah, Holly Condos. Get them on. You're in for a treat. So you have to be on the stage with me. Deborah, Humera, Tony. Come on, come on. We have to get in. So what we are going to have right now is entertainment. It's a stand-up comedy. So the expressions have to show up on the screen when Anshu is going to be talking about. So let me give you a little background of my friend Anshu Moore. Anshu and I, we studied in college together. We both were in our engineering college. He was in, I think, electronics, and I think I was in electrical. So we kind of met each other. And I used to drum and I used to sing on keyboards. And this is after 25 years, we are actually coming together and doing a pretty good, fun performance like this. So I want to invite him to the stage. He's the man who has spent 18 years in corporate life and then decided to follow his passion to become a stand-up comedian. In his first year of comedy in 2016, he was recognized as the rising star of Indian stand-up comedy by the Times Group. That is so cool. Till date, he has performed over 600 shows in India and abroad and has over 30 million views on his YouTube channel. So with that, Anshu, we welcome you to the stage. Let's give a big round of applause for Anshu.
Hey, thank you so much, Jai. Thank you so much. It is such a pleasure being with you guys right now. Although it's some obscene hour out here, it's 5:54 a.m. You know, when I was in corporate life, I spent about 18 years in corporate life. And I used to tell myself that I will become a comedian. And, you know, then life will be easy. I'll get up at like noontime and then I'll have a life of my... I never realized that I would be performing to a laptop at 5:55 a.m. You know, this is now not how I planned it, but so good to see the energy out here. It is actually fantastic. Paddy, you know, I've never seen a more energetic person online, at least. Just full of energy. You know, I'm 40 and I think I'm dead inside. I am like I am done. Like if I see a young face, like I can see Humera. Humera is very young. I can see Joe. I'm assuming Joe, you're young. Actually, all of you are looking so young. Like, I hate young people. I do. I just hate young people. Like all this clear skin, functioning legs. Everything is fine with you guys. You're just so happy all the time. And I'm like, why? You know, I went to a party. Okay, this is way before COVID. Okay, I went to a party. There were a lot of these young guys out there dancing and enjoying. And I walked up to them and I was like, why are you guys so happy? And one of them said, YOLO. Like, what? You're like, you only live once. I'm like, yeah, I understand you only live once. But when you grow up, you have to repay your loans every month. Okay? So settle down. Like, put the energy down. And I've been giving advices to everybody now. I have at 48, I have become that guy who just keeps giving advices to people. Like, if anybody on this show right now is less than 40, here is my advice to you. And write it down. It's coming from a stand-up comedian, very serious stuff, okay? So write it down. On your 39th year, 364th day, take a pill and die. Trust me. Yeah. Nothing good will come out of being in your 40s. Nothing at all. Like, nothing. Trust me, even sex won't be good. Like, it'll just be more matured, which means only quicker. So So it's just like all your dreams right now in your 20s and 30s, because you have so much energy, right? I will become CEO one day. I will head and organize. All of them will be finished by the time you hit your 40s. Then you'll start your own company and call yourself founder CEO. That's me. I did that. I am founder CEO of my own company. One employee, me. Sometimes I send an email to myself only. They're like, yeah, tomorrow is off. I don't know what I'm doing with my life yet. Really don't know. And if you're in your 40s, now you understand this, okay? Time flies very quickly in your 40s. Like in your 20s and 30s, now time flies at its own regular pace. In your 40s, it just flies here. I still remember my 40th birthday party. And it's supposed to be special, right? 40th birthday, I was with my friends. We were in a lounge bar. We were celebrating like mad. Everybody was drinking like mad. I got completely sloshed. So sloshed that my wife had to drive me home. We reached home. My friends were waiting to celebrate my 48th. And I was like, how did this happen so quickly? I have no idea yet. And all my friends are of the same age now. And they're all like, I think they've given up on life. Paddy, I want to be friends with you just for the energy. You know, my friends, and these are school friends, okay? These are childhood friends that I have. All of us, same age. None of my friends are on social media. Like, I am a stand-up comedian. I need people to write good things about me on social media, right? And friends do that the best. None of them are on social media. I don't know how they exist. Like, can you imagine when food comes, they just eat it? I'm like, what? Why won't you take a photograph, send it to people? Like, they just eat the food. It's very weird. You know, in 2019, okay, July 2019, my son went to college, okay, and he went to a different city, okay? So we are in Delhi and he went to Mumbai. And he was so happy going to college, like, you know, freedom and everything. And then COVID happened. So he's back home since March of 2020. He's just sitting at home doing nothing. And I remember, when we were going to drop him to the airport, and we only have one son. And you know how emotional Indians are, right? Like overtly emotional people. So we were at the airport. Everybody was saying bye to him and everybody was crying. Okay, my wife was crying, my parents were crying, my in-laws were crying, our friends were crying because only one son leaving, right? Everybody was crying because he was leaving. And I was crying because now I would have to talk to my wife. I don't know. I think that's why you have kids, right? So that you don't have to talk to each other. Wasn't it written in the Constitution somewhere? No? And I can tell you, like, you know, when I got married, my wife and I, we used to argue a lot. And then we had a kid. And then we got united against the kid. Like, yeah, he's the problem. So he's gone now. And now when kids leave, right, is when you start introspecting on how good a parent you have been. And I've realized that I am such a fraud father. I think all men are. We're just fraud at parenting. We just know how to be politically correct. We just know what to say, the right things. But overall, I think we're just big frauds. And by the way, it starts from day one, okay? Day one. And if you notice, you will realize it. Like day one, you know, the wife would say, honey, I am pregnant. And the guy goes, no, we are pregnant. I'm like, yeah, really? Really, we? I'll tell you a true story. Tell you a true story, okay? My son was born on 31st December, okay? And this is for all the ladies on the show right now. I'll tell you how exactly men think during the process, okay? 31st December, my wife walked up to me in the morning and she was like, honey, my water broke. You know the first thought in my head? Water can't break. And my next immediate thought was 31st December. Really? You had to pick this date? This is going in my head, okay? I didn't say it to her, obviously, right? I'm still married. But But in front of her, I was like, yeah, yeah, baby, let's go. Big moment for us. We reached the hospital. Okay. And my son was born at 2:10 p.m. And they brought my son to me. I was holding him for the first time. The thought in my head should have been 2:10 p.m., 31st December. What a moment. The actual thought in my head was 2:10 p.m., 31st December. I can still make it to the New Year's party. Really, I swear, this is what I was thinking, okay? And my mom was standing next to me at that point of time, okay? And Indian moms have this, okay? And she said something to me that I don't think any mother has said to her son about her grandson. No mother has ever said it, okay? She comes, she looks at him, and she goes, he doesn't look like you. And I was like, what? What? Like, oh my God, Monica cheated? Like, no. But then I was looking at him, so that fatherly feeling came over, right? And I was just like, hey, baby, who's your daddy? And he was looking at me, you will never know. Like, oh my God. We are frauds at parenting. Yeah? We're complete frauds at parenting. But now my son has grown up. Now it's interesting. Yeah, he's gone to college. So, now he treats me like a hero of a heroine-oriented film. You know, I'm just in some side role in his life, but it's fun. I think parenting is a 0 to 18 year project, because after 18 year they're gone and then they don't care, you don't care, and now I look at young parents and I really look at them and I'm like, oh boy, you have so many years to go, especially new parents. Anybody out here who's a new parent during this time? I'm sure there must be somebody, right? They're very cute. Yeah. Like their life has like literally turned upside down. Like they have no idea what is going on in their life when you become a new parent. And then they'll bring their kid and they'll be like, hey, isn't our baby cute? You know, like, seem cute. This is not it. Okay. I can do that, right? Because I've done with the parenting. And I realized parenting, people are now very, very, they're reading too many articles on parenting these days. Like everybody's become so like overprotective about kids. Kids can't do this. Relax. In fact, the advice that I give to young parents is this. Okay. Life is tough. Life is really tough. So you got to give your kids a taste of this tough life early on. You can't be overprotective. Okay. So once in a while, just throw them in the air and don't catch them. It's good. Help them. My wife keeps telling me, she says, why do you talk like this? You're so immature. At 48, you're so immature. I don't know. Hey, tell me one thing. What is immature about this thing? Okay. Every time I fight with my wife or argue with my wife, I block her on WhatsApp. What's wrong with that? Yeah. And she's like, I am sitting right here. I was like, yeah, but you can't message. You're so immature. I'm like, okay. Okay, I'll wrap up. I'll wrap up by saying something from my heart, okay, to you guys. It's a fantastic, fantastic event, first of all. It's been a tough year, 2020, for everyone, right? One of the things that I've realized, I've worked in corporate life for 18 years, and then I became a stand-up comedian. And as a stand-up comedian, you tend to look at everything and try to find the funny in it. Right. And I've realized that if you can somehow find the funny in the darkest situations, in all the chaos that is happening around us, it is so easy to go through life. Like I had a terrible 2020. Okay. Terrible 20. Like even before all this COVID nonsense happened, I lost a friend while he was swimming. Another one of my friends died paragliding. The other day, my wife was asking me, she was like, can you change the light bulb? And I was like, no, I am not into extreme sports. You know, and she was like, you are so immature. I was like, yeah, okay, block on WhatsApp. So, and it is like that, right? So we have to find the funny in things. I'll give you an example. The last thing I'll say out here. I recently lost a very, very close friend of mine. Okay, he bought a treadmill to exercise. Third day running on the treadmill, collapsed. Third day. No, don't feel sad. He didn't die or anything. Okay, He just called me to tell me this. And my first reaction was, if you're not using the treadmill, give it to me. And that's how I lost him as a friend. All right, guys, I think that's my time. I guess we are here to chat. I don't know where, in the lounge or somewhere. But again, thank you so much. Such beautiful faces, smiling. It's so good to see. Thank you so much, guys.
Thank you. Thank you. Let's give it up.
Thank you.
All right, you guys can jump off the stage. You can jump off the ship.
I like how Marit is asking. I love how Marit was asking, did you actually get the treadmill or not?
Did you get the treadmill? We want to know. Did you get it? Yes.
No, I just lost him as a friend, so he never spoke to me.
I think he had no sense of humor about that.
Definitely. Well, thank you so much.
Thank you. That was pretty great.
Loved having you.